A remittance occurs when an individual working in a foreign country sends money back to the home country. Remittances are an important source of income for many developing nations. Number one on this list is Tajikistan, where remittances account for about 35% of GDP. Other nations where remittances are extremely important include Tonga, Moldova, Nepal, Philippines, Bangladesh, Lebanon, Serbia, Guatemala, Jordan, and El Salvador. For Jordan and El Salvador, remittances are still as much as 16% of GDP. In a typical year for the entire world, remittances will usually exceed $300 billion. Another nice thing about remittances is that they tend to be fairly stable. Even in down times, there's only a slight decrease in the level of remittances, and remittances are more stable than foreign investment. The motives for remittances are numerous, but some of the most common ones are listed here. First, there's altruism, simply caring about the people back home and wanting them to do better. Another is exchange. You may be sending money back home, but you expect something in return. It might be something quite tangible, like, for instance, a painting or some craft work, or it might be something quite intangible, such as affection and a lot of phone calls. Insurance is another motive. The people back home may need to pay expensive doctor bills, or maybe a roof in the house collapsed, and they need to somehow make up for the lost income. There is loan repayment, which is common in developing nations, and also very important is investment. It is often the case that money is sent back home, in particular to villages, to help finance schools or help finance infrastructure, or in some way make the village or the town a better place. Of course, these motives and others may all overlap. One interesting feature of remittances is that fairly small sums are sent, yet they are sent quite frequently. For instance, the sender might transmit $300 three different times rather than sending $900 all at once. Why is this? The senders are afraid that if they send too much money all of it once, all of it will be spent. There was one study of remittances from El Salvador. The individuals sending the money wished that the recipients would save about 21% of what was sent. The recipient said that they wanted to save only about 2% of what was sent. One way to enforce some savings discipline is simply to send less right now, and in essence, save money for the people you're sending to. One final point about remittances. The actual gains for the receiving country are not quite as high as the measured numbers for remittances would suggest. For instance, if a Mexican is working in the United States and he is earning dollars and what he wants to do is send money back home using a service such as Western Union, he in essence converts those dollars into Mexican pesos, and in doing so, sending all that money to Mexico, this raises the value of the peso on foreign exchange markets. What that means is that for some other Mexican companies, it is now harder to export to the United States because the value of the peso has strengthened. So some of the benefits of the remittances are in effect given back in the form of more disadvantageous conditions for exporters. To read more about remittances, there's a very good survey article by Dean Yang called Migrant Remittances, and also just Google Economics of Remittances.